Welcome. We've had this scare this afternoon. Is it just a matter of time before coronavirus gets to Australia?
No, not necessarily. For example, with the epidemic of SARS in 2003, we didn't have any cases in Australia. We haven't had any cases of MERS coronavirus either. So it just depends on the number of flights from China and particularly from Wuhan and whether or not someone who's infected gets on one of those flights.
So at the moment, the screening involves handing out a pamphlet and asking people to present if they do have symptoms according to that pamphlet. Is that enough?
I think so. You know, as the Chief Medical Officer said, airport screening isn't fail-safe because people can be incubating the infection and have no symptoms and come into the country and develop symptoms later. However, you know, that's the best we can do at this point. But the other point of detection is in hospitals, in general practice and in the health system in general, that there needs to be a very high index of suspicion when somebody turns up with an unusual pneumonia or who's got respiratory symptoms. They should always be asked their travel history, and if they have come from China, particularly from Wuhan, it's probably good to test and make sure that it isn't this virus.
So tell us what the symptoms are.
The symptoms are could be as simple as a common cold, but it could be more severe with shortness of breath, cough, high fever seems to be the commonest symptom, and a pneumonia-type syndrome is the more severe presentation.
And tell us about how this disease has developed and why there's so much concern about it.
We don't know how it's developed. The assumption is it's a virus that's been in animals that has somehow made the jump from animals to humans, as did SARS coronavirus and MERS coronavirus, but the actual animal source has not been tracked as yet.
We've heard a lot about new viruses over the past decade or so. Is it the case that there is an increasing number of infectious diseases popping up?
Yes, there is. There's an increasing number of serious emerging infections affecting humans that over the last decade or so compared to the previous two decades.
And why is that happening?
Nobody knows really whether it's related to changes in farming or agricultural practices or changes in climate. Nobody really knows, but it's been quite a striking increase in the emergence of new viruses.
But you're optimistic about the ability of modern science to keep them in check?
Yes, but having said that, there's a lot more that we can do to control these epidemics than just drugs and vaccines. You look at Ebola in 2014, for example, even MERS coronavirus, we've controlled epidemics without drugs or vaccines. And those are things like having good surveillance systems to pick up new cases as they occur, which is what we're doing with the targeted airport screening in Australia at the moment, and also being alert in hospitals and health systems to pick up new cases, to isolate people who are suspected of having the disease as soon as possible actually can reduce transmission to zero.
Okay, Ryan McIntyre, thanks so much for talking to us.
It's a pleasure.